trying not to talk too much. But I feel that I should say Happy Holidays, Merry Christmas, and all the other stuff that goes along with this wonderful season, and greet you so that you don't think that we're mad at you or anything. They sound really good, don't they? I'm extremely proud of them. Extremely proud to come to work and enjoy these rehearsals and work really hard with them. They've been working hard since August. Even in the summer, while everyone's having a good time, some of these kids are getting together. They're doing sectionals and practicing our band music. We learned a new show. We learned about maybe 8 or 10 new stand tunes. And we put this show together. So it's not like we spent the last 32 weeks working on 5 tunes. We've been playing a lot of different music and reading a lot of different music. One of the things that I enjoy seeing is during lunch and during study halls, students coming into the band room, asking for keys to the practice rooms. Our practice rooms are full. During middle school band rehearsals, some of our musicians are taking their free time to help the younger kids and work with them. After school, the place is filled with students doing sectionals and working on parts and helping the younger kids. There's just a really, really nice vibe going on. And that's all a byproduct of the art of music. When you study music, that's what happens. And that's why so many of our kids go on to do some wonderful things. Anyway, we'll continue, we'll play some more music, and then I'll talk some more. Dedicated at our students? Well, take a look at, go ahead, stand up. Why not? Jordan broke his knee, and like he can't even walk, he's on crutches, and instead of going to the hospital, he's like, I gotta play. So Jordan over there on the tube. One of the things that we did this year that was different is we allowed the eighth graders the option, if they wanted to, and if they wanted to work really hard, to join the marching band, learn stand tunes, and learn the show. And several of them took advantage of that. One student in particular decided that he wanted to hijack this concert. So he smuggled the music and he worked on the music. And not only that, he showed up for all the sections with all of his section and worked on his part. And then came to me and says, yeah, I'm gonna play in the concert, right? I said, if you sound bad, you're not. We work every day for an hour and are working on, so you can't just come in. You're gonna have to kind of audition. So I'll tell you what, if you come to one of our rehearsals and you show that you can play that music well, then I'll let you play with us. And he did. And I told him he can't play with us. No, I'm only kidding. He's playing with us right now, so I want to acknowledge this young, hardworking musician, Jacob Thurman. You have a program, but anyway, this is one of our favorite tunes in the program. It reminds me of my childhood growing up with Charlie Brown, the pessimist. One more tune and then we're out of here, but I wanted to first of all thank you for coming, thank our school administrators for supporting the arts and allowing us so much time to work with our students, right? Because we could be seeing our students once or twice a week and then we would sound really bad, but we're getting the most out of music because we have time to do it, so thank you for scheduling the way you do. I'd also like to thank my colleagues who I work with every single day. Lindsay Crook, who's sitting in on clarinet. And our new choral director, Victoria McComb, who you will see. And then also Michelle Booth and Jeff Popatic, our elementary school teachers, who are here assisting and helping us. We really look at this whole thing K through 12. I'm not just this high school band director at their middle school. It's like we care about the kids and we want to see them from 5 all the way up to 18. And if some kids stay an extra couple of years, that's fine. I mean, that was our but yeah, we're really fortunate. We've got an outstanding faculty here, and we're really excited for right now, what we have now, but what's to come. So thank you for supporting the arts, and enjoy the rest of the concert. We're going to finish it up with a selection from Pirates of the Caribbean. Thank you very much.
Over here for other parents. Over here, sorry.
bear with us for a few minutes. We're going to clear the front row and set up for the floors.
The first piece we are going to be performing for you today is a popular Christmas carol, but it did not start out that way. This piece was originally written by a Ukrainian composer to be a winter greeting song. It debuted in the U.S. in 1921, at which point Peter Wilhowsky wrote new lyrics and introduced it as a Christmas song. We hope you enjoy Carol of the Bells. The next piece we are going to be performing is a traditional South African mining song. The lyrics to Shosholoza refer to the steam trains that were used to carry migrant miners from Zimbabwe to South Africa. The word Shosholoza itself means go forward, so the song is about hope. We hope you enjoy Shosholoza.
Thank you. next piece we will be performing is an adaptation of the old folk song Green Sleeves. This arrangement was written by Douglas E. Wagner and features a solo flute from our classmate Aaron Field. We would also like to bring our accompanist, Ms. Michelle Booth, for the first time for this piece. We hope you enjoy.
Was written by Yusuf Holst. It is a cappella and has multiple verses, so please hold your applause until the end. We hope you enjoy In the Bleak Midwinter.
Oh.
from a musical called Les Miserables, featuring solos from senior Ryan Struzzieri, senior David Gallagher, and sophomore Nelia Dunn. On behalf of the music department, thank you for attending our concert and enjoy.
I'd like to just introduce myself and just talk really quick. My name is Victoria McComb, and I wanted to thank everyone so much for such a warm welcome to Brockland. I have been really fortunate to work with such amazing colleagues, Michelle Booth, our accompanist, Jeff Papadic, Lindsay Crook, and John Piazza have been so great. We have fabulous administration, and I'm truly blessed to be able to work with these students every morning. So, afternoon. I always say good morning every time they walk in the afternoon because it just resets my day, which is nice. So thank you all so much for supporting the Rockland Music Department. Thanks. Have a good night.